Okay, so I'm Vicky Wheaton, very happy to be here with three young men who have decided to kite surf a charity. These three lads are going to be doing the Kite for COVID challenge, where they are going to be kite surfing the length of Cayman. And this is for ARC, Acts of Random Kindness. So without further ado, let's meet the three athletes, shall we? First of all, what's your name?
My name is Ben.
And how old are you?
I am 11.
I'm Jake Fagan, I'm 12.
12?
I'm Zach, and I'm also 12.
12 years old, my goodness. So how long have you guys been kite surfing for? You all learned how to kite surf together, yes?
Yes, 2 years.
2 years ago, all right. And how did it start off? What got you interested in kite surfing?
It was my birthday present to learn how to kite surf. And so I asked them if they also wanted to, and then we did it together.
Okay. So you guys went in with him on his birthday gift and you learned how to kite surf?
Yes.
And where did you learn how to kite surf?
At Barker's with John.
Cayman kite surfing.
Cayman kite surfing, all right. How did you like it from the beginning? Ben, how did you find it at the beginning? Was it easy? Was it difficult?
Well, at the beginning it was quite difficult because there was so much to learn. But then once you started getting it, then it was lots of fun.
All right, how long would you say it took you to really get into it? How many lessons?
About five lessons.
Okay. And Jake?
It's kind of peaceful for me, like just being out on the water with the wind.
So did you pick it up pretty quickly?
Yeah.
Any problems at the beginning, or it was just smooth sailing? Smooth surfing?
Yeah, pretty smooth surfing.
It was pretty smooth surfing?
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
Zach?
Well, for me, it was kind of a slow start because, like, in the first couple of lessons, I kept, like, flying and landing on my face. So I had to go to a little bit of a smaller kite, but it was really fun from the first two lessons.
So after some plastic surgery,
yeah,
you were right back to it.
Yes.
Fantastic. Now, this is an amazing challenge. I mean, the length of Cayman, how long is that? How far is that?
22 miles.
That is really quite a distance. Who came up with the idea for this challenge?
I came up with the idea for it.
Okay.
I already had the name in my head, Kite for COVID, and that's when it started.
All right. And when did this come to you? How long has this been ruminating?
Well, when kite surfing opened up, that was 2 weeks ago. And then basically the day after that, I started thinking about it.
Okay.
But it only properly started last week.
Last week?
Yeah.
So really, this has been pretty quick. I mean, from actually deciding upon it, it's only been about a week, right?
Yeah.
Okay. What made you choose ARC? Why ARC in particular?
Well, because ARC is making meals for people who've lost their jobs. And we thought it would be good because it's stopping people in Cayman from starving, and ARC is running out of money, so we thought that would be a good charity to choose.
Fantastic. And Ben, how are you feeling about this challenge? Are you feeling confident about it?
Yeah, it's very exciting, also a little nervous, but let's see how it goes.
Exactly. Let's see how it goes. Jake, how are you feeling about the challenge?
I feel confident about it, and I just hope that we can raise enough money.
What's your goal?
$10,000, but we've reached it already, so now it's $15,000.
You've reached it already?
Yeah.
That's amazing. Okay, so we're upping the goal, and that's the thing to do, really. That's it. If you've reached it this early, just aim for higher, because, I mean, we all know ARC could use every single penny. How are you feeling about the challenge, Zach?
I'm feeling quite confident. It's just, I don't think I'll have enough endurance for it because I used to be doing activities or sports every day after school, but I haven't really been doing much exercise through quarantine.
Right.
Through quarantine, but I've started up, so I think I could be able to, but that's my only real worry.
Your only concern is the endurance. But from what I hear, the three of you have gone at this really professionally. You've not just sort of said, okay, we're just gonna get into it and see how it goes. You've actually been physically training for this, correct?
Yes.
Ben, how have you been training?
We've been doing running, swimming, kayaking and HIIT workouts.
All right, Jake, so all three of you have been doing the same thing?
Yes.
Yep, and how many hours would you say that you're spending a day preparing for this?
I think it's an hour and a half to 2 hours. Yesterday we did a 10K cycle. It was kind of like a rest day. So
a 10K cycle was a rest day?
Yeah.
I see.
But we're also spending time going around neighborhoods close to us to ask for donations.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Very nice, while practicing social distancing.
Yeah.
Yes, exactly. Ben, what's your biggest concern about this?
Mine's kind of the same as Zach's. I don't know if we can do it, but I'm pretty sure we can.
Pretty sure you can? Now, from what I've gathered, the way that the rules work, because you're doing the length of Grand Cayman, but what you're actually going to be doing, you're going to be measuring it with GPS, is that correct?
Yes.
It's an app that can measure the distance that you've covered.
Yeah.
So you're going to be going, you're going to be doing laps back and forth to the South Sound Reef. I believe the rules that have been set for this is that you can't let go of the kite at any time. But you're obviously going to have your families here ready to go. And if you need some water or something, there's a signal that you're going to give them. They will come out to give you the water, but you're not allowed to let go of the kite at any time. Is that right?
Yeah, we can't land it.
Right. Or is that news to you, Zach? What? Well, I don't remember signing up for that. Did Jake not tell you that part of the contract?
I don't really remember.
And that's the problem, you see, folks. This is what happens to all of us. We all agree to things in the spur of the moment, and then the next day we don't remember. We don't remember ever saying yes. I see. So, and I believe your parents are ready to go. Your dad said that he has done some kite surfing, but he doesn't think that he could probably kite surf out to save you, so he reckons he's going to take a boat.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, have any of you got any concerns about the flagle breaking?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, the flagle, you never know what's going to happen.
It's pretty delicate, so we're not sure if being out for so long might damage it.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, on a windy day, if the wind really picks up, a flagle can go like that. It's very, very concerning. But, I mean, the three of you are willing to risk it, which is wonderful. Now, if for whatever reason, and we realise, of course, that kite surfing is very, very much dependent on the weather.
Yes.
And the weather can change at any moment. So if you're doing this, if you're doing your laps and all of a sudden the wind dies or it picks up to the point that it's dangerous, I presume that we have got a caveat that for safety purposes, we would stop and then we would resume.
The following day or the following time is the next good wind.
Yeah, absolutely.
We don't want to take risks. We don't want to hurt anybody.
No, I don't want you to hurt anybody either or yourselves. That would be good. I'm sure your parents don't particularly want you out there in 120 mile per hour winds either.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. But that's fantastic. I mean, I think the most important thing is that you're going for this challenge. You're planning to do it in a day. But obviously, as I said, if the weather changes, which none of us can predict, your plan is no matter what, you're going to be covering that distance, right, for charity?
Yes.
Now, I asked you this earlier. Let's see if the estimates have changed at all. Ben, how long is it going to take for you to complete this challenge?
2.5 hours.
2.5 hours. Should we say 2 hours and 32 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay. Jake, how long is it going to take you?
Between 2 to 3 hours.
Between 2 to 3 hours?
And 3 to 4.
Oh, 3 to 4. I see. Somebody slightly changed their answer. Have you told ARC? I presume that you have told ARC that you're doing this.
Yes.
And they're behind you 100%, I'm sure.
Yes.
All three of you attend the prep school, is that correct?
Yeah.
Yes.
All right. And how does the prep school know about this?
Yeah,
they're supporting.
And they're behind you 100%. But I'm sure they're also telling you to be very careful.
Yeah, I think the principal's coming down to watch for a bit, which will be cool.
The principal's coming to watch?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness me. Okay, so we have to wrap up now, but let's run down how people can donate. So they can obviously donate cash, they can write checks to ARC, they can donate online to the family account which has been set aside for the donations, or to the ARC bank accounts, and they can go online. But the most important thing, folks, please, please remember, when you donate, just please make a note that it's Kite for COVID. If you write a check, put Kite for COVID on it. If you're donating to a bank under the notes, please put Kite for COVID, because these lads, they're taking on a big challenge and they need to know that the money is going in there to support them. And we wish them every single success. Guys, this is fantastic. I'm sure ARC is thrilled. We're all excited to hear how this goes. No broken bones. And remember, watch out for the flagle. Ben, Jake, Zach, thank you so much for being with us. I'm Vicky Wheaton, Cayman Campus. Thanks for being with us.